I welcome you to this session. It's called New to DevConf. The session is for those who are new to DevConf, but also for the people that have been to DevConf before. You're all welcome to participate in this session and in DevConf in general. The session is also for those people that are active within Debian and also for those who are not active in Debian. You're all welcome to participate. For those who are not active, whether you want to get involved, whether you don't plan to get involved, you're still welcome to join this session. And it is also up to you how you would like to participate, if you want to participate actively, if you want to participate quietly, which is also called lurking. You're very welcome to be here and also during the rest of DevConf. Here you see the Debian diversity statements, which also sets this very clear. The Debian project welcomes and encourages participation by everyone. With this we mean no matter how you identify yourself or how others perceive you, we welcome you. We welcome contributions from everyone as long as they interactive constructively with our community. While much of the work in our project is technical by nature, we value and encourage contributions from those with expertise in other areas and welcome them in our community. The Debian project is quite diverse in the way it's set up. It's not just a technical project. Like all the artwork you see and other things, this is also part what makes up the Debian community, all the translation work, and we value all these people very much on a similar level.
And if you are attending a DevConf, you are agree to the Debian Code of Conduct. So if you don't see the Debian Code of Conduct, you received a paper with map in the Code of Conduct in press. So you should read.
Okay. Yeah, DevConf is committed to be a safe and welcoming environment for all participants. Like said, you can see the DevConf Code of Conduct and also the Debian Code of Conduct for more details. It's part of your welcome bag and also visible on various places across the venue.
Yeah. At the front desk, we put on the wall. And which more?
Maybe we should introduce ourselves also.
Oh, yeah. I'm Adriana. I'm part of the local team. And I'm part of the anti-harassment team for DevConf this year, and I'm also contributing with translation from English to Portuguese. Just it.
My name is Rhonda. My pronouns are she and her, and I've been with Debian since about 20 years now, and I recently started with the diversity team, which is the aim to make it more visible to the outside that Debian doesn't just have the diversity statement, but also lives up to it, and we want to increase the visibility of the diversity that Debian represents to make it clear that Debian is welcoming everyone. If you have any issues, if something might happen, there is the anti-harassment team you can contact under either under anti-harassment or at debian.org, or here on site, either Adriana, Steve McIntyre, or myself, and we will see how to make it more comfortable for you in case anything happened. Let's start off with a short question. Who of you, for whom in the audience is this the first DevConf? Please raise your hand.
It's mine.
That's a fair amount. Very welcome. And who has been to DevConf before? You're also very welcome. These were the first two parts of this session that we started off with welcoming everybody and also speaking about the diversity statement and the code of conduct. We will continue with speaking about some tips and tricks how you can get most out of DevConf for yourself and how you can enjoy the rest of the week. And also after that, we will speak a bit of a bit more and also at the end then hear a bit stories from people who have been to DevConf before and also from those who come who are new to DevConf. First for the site information. I'm just finding, there's the cursor. Let's see. For those who have been to the welcoming session in the morning, you already know this map. It's also inside your badge. So if you take the paper out and unfold it, you have this map inside your badge every time, all the time with you. We are now in the room 4, which is the big talk room. Next to it, in the room 5, is the mini auditorium, which is the next talk room, and the third bigger talk room, which also has video coverage, is the video conferencia room, number 6. And behind that is the front desk, where you all got your badges from, so you probably know it already. You can always turn to the front desk if you have any questions. You can always also turn to people with blue shirts that are the local team. The people with the orange shirts are people that are part of the welcoming team, which always will also be around for you to be there for questions that might arise. We have several hack labs. 8 is the quiet hack lab, and behind that 9 is the noisy hack lab, which also can be quite quiet at some times, yes. But the quiet hack lab is specifically aimed to be quiet. in the noisy hack labs, you can sit together and work on stuff and chat with each other without having any bad thoughts to disturb anyone else. Behind the front desk, there is the job fair, which might still be going on or sort of...
Just today.
It was just today. Behind that is the restaurant, which is our food gathering for lunch and dinner during the week times for tonight and tomorrow lunch and dinner. The food will be prepared in the Hotel International Inn.
National
Inn. Which is when you exit at the top, at the number 1, and also go in the opposite direction of the arrow, you come to the block where the hotel is, where there is the food for the weekend. But also on the 13th and on the 12th floor, there's additional hack labs. And that's the main venue where people are staying.
Yeah, and you can check the catering, the food menu at week catering page. We wrote all the options and the schedule for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So you can check to have more information about food in general.
On the DebConf wiki, which is wiki.debian.org/debconf/19, which is the entrance page for the DebConf wiki for this year, you can find not just the catering and food page, but also about the day trip and a lot of other information. You have an FAQ there, and a lot of other things that are valuable if you want to look it up there. There are two mailing lists. One, you probably very likely are subscribed to it because it's the DebConf announced mailing list. We're sending out daily mails about what's going on during DebConf, information for the coming day. Then there's also the DebConf discuss mailing list, in which people discuss various things like, I want to make a tour through the city, someone likes to join in, or something else, and it's for unmoderated information discussion between people, attendees here at DebConf. There are some more communication channels. One is on IRC, which is in #DebConf. That's the main discussion channel. You also have a schedule bot there, which will remind you about upcoming talks. And you can also ask on that channel, has someone seen a person you're looking for? So you can sort of play little big brother through communication on IRC. if you want to hang out with someone or chat about a certain bug report or anything like that, that's where IRC comes in handy. It's since last year, people also started to create a channel on Telegram, which is unfortunately a non-free service, but if you like to chat on there with others, feel free to join the Telegram channel too.
DebConf channel.
Yeah. This is the... Yeah, here you see all the announcement of the DC schedule bot and some other people hanging out and chatting along. About communication with others, the Debian conference, DebConf, is a very social event. It's not just a conference, but there's a lot of other stuff going on along, and it really, really helps to communicate with, to talk to a lot of people, because it changes completely the way you read the next mail from the same person. When you just communicate electronically, you don't really have a feeling for the person behind it. And here at DebConf, you have the chance to talk with a lot of people involved in Debian and get to know them and get a feeling for how their mail might be read, and the next time you might not get something into the wrong throat and get angry about a mail or something like that. So try to speak with as many people as you wish or as you feel comfortable with. Keep in mind, most people here at DebConf, but in general, are not native English speakers. So if you use some slang terms, if you are a native speaker and speak very fastly, it might be an issue for others to understand you. And it might sometimes be a barrier to ask people to speak slower. And so try to think about that not everyone here, in fact, most people here are not native English speakers. And also that might take away a bit a shyness from you, because don't try to be perfect in your English. People will understand you nevertheless.
And if you are trying, studying something and need help, you can talk to people or send a message on IRC channel requesting help. People probably will help you.
Like Bernal mentioned before already, we need volunteers to run this service here, especially the video team. Stay in the room afterwards if you want to have video team training, if you want to get to know how to operate this, to make it also possible for people who are not here to attend DevConf through the video streaming. But also there are more than one tracks besides each other's, and you might want to also see sometimes sessions in multiple rooms. So the video team is very helpful with that, because all the talks in the video rooms are also recorded and you can watch them later.
Yeah. And you can check the tasks here and apply. For example, here we don't have volunteers, but you can check the date and which kind of work you would like to do.
Yeah, it's on DevConf19, devconf.org/volunteers, and you can sign up there for specific tasks and find your way into helping out and making this a success. You might also happen to notice on the 13th floor of the hotel, there's also a bar which is opening at the evening. Bring your own cup with you, because the disposable cups are out. That's every one of you had a cup in your goodie bag, so bring it along if you want to have beer. There might also be people around who play cards. There's a card game called Mao, which is quite famous in Debian rounds. Don't ask about the rules. Just join in the sessions and try to enjoy it. But you don't feel obliged to try it. If you don't like to, that's fine too. Tomorrow, there will be the key signing session. If you signed up with your fingerprint in the registration form, tomorrow at 3 PM, there will be the session about key signing, where the checksum of the file, which already has been sent to the DevConf Discuss mailing list, will be read. So check your fingerprint in the file, check the checksum of the file, read the mail that was sent to DevConf Discuss if you take part in the key signing. Is there any questions so far?
Do the university has a schedule for the Hack Labs opening and closing times?
Pardon?
The university here, if someone would like to stay after the talks in the Hack Labs, or it will
How
be
long?
Closed.
Will the Hack Labs here in the university be open?
There we have the Noise Hack Lab, room B, and quite Hack Labs as well. But we will open at 9 and close at 7. And we will move to the hotel Hack Lab.
Hi, thank you.
Hey.
about the key signing party. It's happening only today or for the rest of the week?
It will happen throughout the rest of the week, but tomorrow at 3 there will be a public reading of the checksum of the file so that everyone can assure that they have the same file and that the fingerprint information therein. But it will be explained in details tomorrow during the session.
Thank you.
And one more information. If you would like to schedule a meeting, we have a meeting room at 12th floor at Hotel National Inn Hotel. We can use.
If you have any idea for any ad hoc session that hasn't been in the schedule yet, just head up to the front desk. They are willing to help you to set that up and get the information out.
Hi. Thank you for the introduction. About the key signing, in the instructions says that we should print the file, and I was wondering if you know where can we print that file.
Personally, I haven't printed a file since a few years. I always use my laptop. You can, whatever works for you. Printed is usually more convenient because you just check it off and then do it later at home. Mm-hmm. But whatever works for you.
Thank you.
Okay.
So I would like to hear some stories. Probably we start out with someone who has been to DevConf before, who might talk about their first impression of DevConf or how they came to it. Someone willing to do that?
Hi, my name is Andreas Tiller. I was even on DevConf Zero in Bordeaux, but I skipped some. I have not really a story, but what you said previously, that it helps if you read an email of a person you know in person from a DevConf, it works also the other way around. Sometimes you have read emails from people and then you are happy to meet this person and maybe the person looks different than you expect or so, but it's easier if you have read something from them. So if you read the mailing list, it also helps the other way around. But I fully agree, as you said. And if you want to have questions about other DevConf, just ask me.
Feel free.
Well, I have started to attend DevConf in 2012 in Managua, Nicaragua. It was very exciting because I could meet for the first time to many Debian maintainers and developers, and also people contributing in another way. And this was possible because I met to Gunnar Wolf in Mexico City, because of a teacher. I studied sociology in the UNAM in Mexico. So I was doing a research for my bachelor degree thesis about the Debian project. And then I got deeper in the technical way and I realized that I like more to work with computer stuff in a technical way than than the social sciences. And then I start to contributing, doing some translations from English to Spanish in the Debian Spanish localization team, and also organizing some events in Mexico or helping to organize them, like the Debian Day or some release or install party. And then I am learning how to do Debian packaging and well, in the future maybe helping the reproducible build team. So well, this is my story and how I arrived to DevConf, and I'm very happy to be here always as possible, sharing nice experiences. Thank you.
Thank you. Someone for whom this is the first DevConf who might want to share what their experience so far is, impression, what they plan to do?
Oh my god. Hey, first of all, when DevConf started, I arrived here using Arch Linux, and now I am using Debian. So this is really important. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, that's the first thing. So I'm here because a friend of mine have been to the last one, to the last DevConf, and he said, it's super nice that we could meet people, like super nice people, and we could learn lots of new things. And so I came, and I'm not that connected with the free software community at all. I'm starting like this path right now. So I liked it very much because I'm able to talk to so many people that can like help me and tell me what they do, and then I have like so many paths to go. I'm even like, oh my god, what do I do, because I want to contribute, but there's so many things to do. And so I thought it's pretty nice, and congratulations for everything, because the organization is also
the organization is also really
thank you.
And the bottom.
Is someone else maybe? I think they might be working on the microphone.
Since I'm here, I might as well say something. she mentioned that, you know, when you start out, there's all these paths and all these exciting directions you can go into, and so many projects you want to get involved with, and you don't know which way to go to. And once you go down one route, you find two or three more. It never gets better. There's just more stuff. But it's awesome and you'll love it. So I think it's good. Continue and find something you like and stick with it. If you don't like something, don't stick with it for too long, because there's so many other things that you can work on. So there's no reason to get stuck in something and be unhappy with it. If you really don't like something, just try something else, because there's so many places where you can contribute and where your contributions will be welcomed. So go for it.
I think with that we somehow can sort of conclude this session. We can stay here, chat, exchange stuff with each other. Unless someone has some pressing question left that they want to put out. So thank you all for having been here to this session, but thank you even more for being here at DevConf, and I wish you a very nice conference.